Namaste, dear students. By now, we are well aware of the application of Ohm's law. Combination of resistances in series and parallel. In today's session, we are going to talk about effects of electricity. There are many effects of electricity, but we will primarily talk about the heating effects of current. At the end of this session, you will be able to relate processes and phenomena with causes and effects, apply scientific concepts in daily life and solving problems. We know that a battery or a cell is a source of electrical energy. The chemical reaction within the cell generates the potential difference between its two terminals that sets the electrons in motion to flow the current through a resistor or a system of resistors connected to the battery. To maintain the current, the source has to keep on expending its energy. Where does this energy go? A part of the source energy in maintaining the current may be consumed into useful work, like rotating the blades of an electric fan or heat, but rest of the source energy may be expended in wasteful heat to raise the temperature of the gadget. We often observe this in our everyday life. For example, an electric fan or an electric bulb becomes warm if used continuously for a longer time. On the other hand, if the electric circuit is purely resistive, that is, a configuration of resistors only connected to a battery, the source energy continually gets dissipated entirely in the form of heat. This is known as heating effect of electric current. This effect is utilized in devices such as electric heater, electric iron, etc. Consider a current I flowing through a resistor of resistance R. Let the potential difference across it be V. Let T be the time during which a charge Q flows across. So, the work done in moving a charge Q through a potential difference V is given by V into Q. Please remember this. The work done is given by V into Q. Therefore, the source must supply energy equal to VQ in time T. Now, the power input into the circuit by the source is denoted by the letter P and is given by the formula work done upon time. Power is equal to VQ, which is nothing but the work done, divided by time. In other words, I can say it is the energy supplied to the circuit by the source in time T and is given by the formula power into time, which is VIT. What happens to the energy expended by the source? This energy gets dissipated in the resistor as heat. Thus, for a steady current I, the amount of heat H produced in time T is given by the formula H equals VIT. Apply the Ohm's law, which is V equals IR. If I substitute IR in place of V I get H equals I square RT. This is known as Joule's law of heating. The law implies that heat produced in a resistor is directly proportional to the square of current for a given resistance, directly proportional to the resistance for a given current, and directly proportional to the time for which the current flows through the resistor. The generation of heat in a conductor is an inevitable consequence of electric current. In many cases, it is undesirable as it converts useful electrical energy into heat. In electrical circuits, the unavoidable heating can increase the temperature of the components and alter their properties. However, heating effect of electric current has many useful applications. The electric laundry iron, electric toaster, electric oven, electric kettle, and electric heater are some of the familiar devices based on Joule's heating effect. The electric heating is also used to produce light, as in an electric bulb. Here, the filament must retain as much of the heat generated as it is possible so that it gets very hot and emits light. It must not melt at such high temperatures. A strong metal with high melting point, such as tungsten, the melting point of tungsten is 3380 degrees Celsius, is used for making bulb filaments. The filament used should be thermally isolated as much as possible using insulating support. The bulbs are usually filled with chemically inactive nitrogen and argon gases to prolong the life of filament. Most of the power consumed by the filament appears as heat, and a small part of it is in the form of light radiated. Another common application of Joule's heating is a fuse, which is used in electric circuits. It protects the circuits and appliances by stopping the flow of any unduly high electric current. The fuse is always placed in series with the device. It consists of a piece of wire made of a metal or an alloy of appropriate melting point, for example, aluminium, copper, iron, lead, etc. If a current larger than the specified value flows through the circuit, the temperature of the fuse wire increases. This melts the fuse wire and breaks the circuit. The fuse wire is usually encased in a cartridge of porcelain or similar material with metallic ends. The fuses used for domestic purposes are rated as 1 ampere, 2 ampere, 3 ampere, 5 ampere, 10 ampere, etc. For an electric iron, which consumes 1 kilowatt electric power, when operated at 220 volt, we use the formula power equals voltage into current. Substituting the values, we calculate the value of current as power divided by voltage, which is 1000 divided by 220 ampere. The answer comes out to be 4.54 ampere that is flowing in the circuit. So now if I have to decide the value of fuse, I know in this case a fuse of 5 ampere must be used. These days, miniature circuit breakers called MCBs are increasingly being used in place of fuses. These are switches which automatically turn off when current in a circuit exceeds the safe limit. You turn them on and the circuit is once again complete. But don't forget to look for ISI mark on MCBs also. You have studied in your earlier classes that the rate of doing work is power. This is also the rate of consumption of energy. Now, the rate at which electrical energy is dissipated or consumed in an electric circuit is called electric power. The power P is given by the formula P is equal to VI. Remember, it's the VIP formula. Or I can write it as power equals I square R, which is also equal to V square by R. You must be wondering how we have got this formula. Remember Ohm's law, V equals IR. Using the Ohm's law in the VIP formula, I have got two new formulas for power, I square R and V square upon R. The SI unit of electric power is watt. It is the power consumed by a device that carries 1 ampere of current when operated at a potential difference of 1 volt. Thus, 1 watt equals 1 volt into 1 ampere. The unit watt is very small. Therefore, in actual practice, we use a much larger unit called kilowatt. It is equal to 1000 watts. Since electrical energy is the product of power and time, therefore the unit of electrical energy is watt hour. 1 watt hour is the energy consumed when 1 watt of power is used for 1 hour. The commercial unit of electrical energy is kilowatt hour, commonly known as unit. 1 kilowatt hour equals 1 kilowatt into 1 hour. We know there are 1000 watts in 1 kilowatt and there are 3600 seconds in 1 hour. So, in place of 1 kilowatt, I substitute 1000 watt, and in place of 1 hour, I substitute 3600 seconds. When I multiply the two, the answer is 3.6 into 10 raised to power 6 watt seconds. This can also be replaced by the unit joule. So 1 kilowatt hour equals 3.6 into 10 raised to power 6 joules. Many people think that electrons are consumed in an electric circuit. This is wrong. We pay the electricity board or electric company to provide energy to move electrons through the electric gadgets like electric bulb, fan, engines, etc. We pay for the energy that we use. So before we close this session, let us pledge to save electricity as it is a form of energy. By doing this, we not only save our money, which is spent on the electricity bill, but we also conserve energy and save our environment. You can now calculate your electricity bill by knowing the number of units consumed and the price of each unit. In the coming lessons, we will explore other effects of electricity like the magnetic effects. Till then, keep observing, keep questioning, and keep practicing. Namaste.